Hello and welcome to this special program on aged care services, which will also focus on some community-based activities available to those who enjoy participating in recreation and even learning some new skills. Also on today's program, we look at aged care facilities from Coburn to Ellenbrook. We visit the Independent Living Centre and show you how to enjoy that perfect meal from your very own home chef. Today we're at the Trinity School for Seniors, this lovely setting in the famous Trinity Arcade, linking Hay Street to St George's Terrace, Perth, offers around 110 classes for over 600 attendees every week. And these activities for the over 55s have been offered for more than 30 years. Now with our first report, here's Nathan. From photography and languages to yoga, dance and tai chi, poetry and even current affairs. One of the courses running today is the art class, which is being coordinated by Ruth Cohen, who is one of 54 tutors here. The great thing about these courses are the resulting friendships that grow between all those who participate. Wouldn't you agree, Ruth?
It's fabulous. Fabulous to come to work. Russell?
Tell us about the art class.
The art classes at Trinity are wonderful because so many friendships are born during the time that the students come to paint. So many people are from different cultures, they speak many different languages, and a lot of their life experiences comes through in their art, and a lot of the barriers and misunderstandings about other people's differences, they just dissolve. So it's a wonderful background for making new friends, to feel part of the community, but more importantly, to feel safe and secure in an environment that really is dedicated to their well-being. So the commitment is strong, it's visible, and we have access to the management and the coordinators to assist anyone that comes here to be supported. Maybe it's their language difficulties, maybe it's their frailty. We make sure that they're taken care of.
Ruth, congratulations and thanks for allowing us into your art class.
You're more than welcome.
Now here's Linda McCarthy with a few words of wisdom from the students.
Thanks, Russell. I never knew there'd be so many classes on offer here. I've had a look through this semester's programme and there are so many topics to choose from. There's got to be something for everyone. So, Norman, we've been admiring your artwork. What do you think about coming to this centre?
Oh, it's absolutely brilliant. The companionship and everything else, it is really great.
A friend told me about this place and I absolutely love coming here. This is the second term that I've been, and this is my first painting.
I chose a drawing class because Carrie's a very good teacher, and I've always loved drawing.
So do you make quite a few friendships coming here?
Lots of friends. It's the ideal place for any retired person. It's cheap. The companionship is fantastic.
I think most of us probably were so busy in our lives that we've had no time to do something like this. And now it's just an opportunity for me and I just adore it.
And do you plan to take any other classes?
Well, I may go to choir.
Good for you.
Yeah, I have made a lot of friends and the companionship's good and you get to people from all walks of life. So it's fascinating, yeah, it's great.
Trinity School for Seniors is one of the best places in Perth. You could come here, meet friends, follow any hobby or lesson that you wish, and there's no pressure at all.
Well, I'm 105 years old, and I've been coming to School for Seniors since it started, and I've learned quite a lot coming here and met up with a lot of friends.
Well, that all seems really interesting. I think I might even put my name down. There's so much to choose from.
This is one of Trinity School for Seniors' hidden gems, the library known as the Claire Casey Centre, officially opened in 1998 and referred to as their Labour of Love. The library has had an enormous and ever-growing selection of donated books, DVDs and CDs, all of which was lovingly catalogued and labelled by its original founders, Ken Price and his lovely wife, Kath. Ken, tell us just a little bit more about this library.
Yes, just quickly, Claire Casey was one of the co-founders of the Trinity School for Seniors 32 years ago. She was a great educationalist and she contributed to Reader's Digest and National Geographic. I think she forgot to cancel her subscriptions and so She lived in a small unit surrounded by cardboard boxes, cellophane packets of DVDs, videos and library books, and thought the best place to get rid of them was to donate them to Trinity School for Seniors. And so Kath and I had the job over many weeks during the summer holidays of opening the boxes, cataloguing them and setting them up on the shelves, as you can see here, for the benefit of the students.
Well, Ken, you've done a fantastic job, both you and your lovely wife, Kath, and thank you very much for allowing us into your library. It's fantastic. Well done.
It's our pleasure. A pleasure to have you.
And now, here's Carolee. Now, what I think is one of our city's best-kept secrets is that anyone can wander into this historical landmark of ours and enjoy a cuppa made by one of the centre's friendly volunteers and have a tranquil escape from retail therapy or the city's hustle and bustle. And why wouldn't you want to, with so many good-looking people in here, like Wendy or one of these good ladies, or indeed, my dear mum? So we hope that you've enjoyed today's program and learning about some of the options we still have as individuals as we get older, and hopefully with more time to pursue new interests. Until next time, take care and stay safe.